The wounds are still raw 1 year after that shooting at the Azana Spa.
The question I struggle with is why.
A crowd gathered tonight to remember Zena Daniel, Carrie Roebuck, and Maylin Lind, who were all murdered, and the four other women hurt in that attack. Tonight's vigil was more than just a memorial. There was an underlying message about domestic violence. Annie Scholl spoke with the victims' family members tonight. Annie?
Well, Courtney, the salon was closed today so those victims' families could come and privately remember their loved ones on this somber anniversary. But tonight, they were in Milwaukee with a powerful message that the victims will never be forgotten and the fight will never end to put a stop to domestic violence. Candlelight, prayer, and a moment of silence for the three women killed 1 year ago at the Azana Spa in Brookfield. Carrie Roebuck, Maylin Lind, and Zena Daniel.
It's been very hard, and we miss her every day.
Elvin Daniel is Zena's brother. She survived years of domestic abuse at the hands of her husband, Radcliffe Hutton, before he went into the salon and started shooting.
I keep asking, how many more people have to get killed before we pass sensible gun laws?
It's a question of why that still haunts the victims' loved ones.
Carrie lived her life knowing that when she came home, she was safe and that I would protect her at all costs. I struggle every day knowing that there was nothing I can do.
Sean Scheffler was Carrie Roebuck's boyfriend and says what happened that day was senseless and has to stop.
Never did she think that this place of tranquility would become the place of her nightmares.
And while countless tears have been shed for Zena, Carrie, and Maylin, it's their strength that will be remembered.
She wanted to become a wonderful wife. She became a wonderful wife.
And it's your strength they're counting on to make sure it never happens again.
Come forward. That's the first thing. First step is to come forward.
And also at tonight's vigil, members of the Sikh temple and a woman who lost her sister in the Sandy Hook shooting simply in the audience to offer their support. Live in Brookfield, Annie Scholl, today's TMJ4.
Okay, thank you, Annie. And today's TMJ4 wants to help stop the violence. So we are holding a phone bank tomorrow to help victims. It runs from 3 to 6:30. Experts will be here to answer your questions. Calls are free and anonymous. The